Bharathirajaa, the veteran of many blockbusters in Tamil, opens up on his 2008 release Bommalaatam. It's a metaphor for cinema. He goes back to his days of childhood in the village where there were Bommalaatam artists touring village to village, narrating tales from the Puranas, the Ramayana, the Mahabharata. The image of the puppeteer manipulating the puppets to recreate the life of men and women and children and tell stories about everyday life fascinated the future director. He talks about the magic in the fingers of the puppeteer that move to tell those wonderful stories.
இப்போ நீங்கள் வந்து பின்னாடி வந்து நான் இது பண்ணுறேன், ஷேடோவில் தான் நீங்கள் பார்க்குறீங்க. நீங்கள் எட்டி பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அது வேறு, என் விரல் வாடிட்டுருக்கும், உண்மையை வேறு. வாட் யூ ஹவ் சீன் இஸ் ஃப்ரீ, த ட்ரூத் இஸ் என்டையர்லி டிஃபரண்ட். இது பொம்மை தான். வாட் யூ ஹவ் சீன், வாட் யூ ஆர் டிஸ்கஸிங் எவ்ரி திங்ஸ், அது உங்களுக்கு தெரிகிற இல்யூஷன் மட்டும் தான் நீங்கள் பிலீவ் பண்ணுறீங்க.
சினிமா has not forgotten its connection with puppetry. Tamil films have romanced puppetry on screen. This a scene from another blockbuster of Kamala Hassan, Indian, set against the backdrop of the freedom struggle, presents puppetry as an important medium of mass communication. In those days, it was a means of mass communication meant to educate the masses on important issues that needed the understanding and the participation of the masses. It also has aspects of the mass leader reaching out to his audience, trying to speak to many from one point of enunciation. India's ancient storytelling traditions have kept alive interest in the legends of Lord Krishna, and the Bhagavata Parayanam is one of the oldest storytelling traditions we have in India. Puppetry has had a significant contribution to make in sustaining that tradition. Like Shakespeare, Bharathirajaa too uses Bommalaatam as the metaphor for cinema. His 2008 film Bommalaatam is not about puppetry, but it is informed by the philosophy of puppetry. It is about the director of a film who is the puppeteer. While the film narrates the investigation into a murder, and while all fingers point to the director, he goes about his task, moving his characters around and engaging with the audience at the same time, thus controlling the narrative to engage everyone within the circle of that spectacle. When asked to explain his choice of the title Bommalaatam for the film, Bharathirajaa opens up about Bommalaatam.
அந்த டைட்டில் வந்து பொம்மல் ஆட்டம்ன்றது வந்து எப்படி சார் அந்த டைட்டில் எதுக்கு இருக்கீங்க?
அதாவது நீங்க பாத்தீங்க, இது ஒரு வித்தனாது
Reality. He gives you the illusion of reality. And puppetry does the same. Everybody knows they are puppets. And everybody knows they are not real. But the magic in the manipulative fingers of the puppeteer turns this world of illusion into reality. And the audience is invited into that circle where they suspend their disbelief to engage in a narrative about their own lives, hence Bommalatam. Thirukkural, attributed to the sage Thiruvalluvar and a classic Tamil text which is called the Veda of the Tamils and has 1,330 couplets on every aspect of human conduct, has a chapter titled Shame. It is about man's moral conduct. The sage Thiruvalluvar uses the word Nanam for shame as a pun. Nanam can mean shame, also means the strings by which the puppeteer controls the puppet. Couplet 1020 says, Nanahatillar yakka marappavai nanal yermaruttiyetru. It means, a man's movement in society without his moral self-control that is informed by a sense of shame is no better than a puppet show controlled by leading strings. On the battlefield of Kurukshetra is despondent and thinks that he has to fight. Krishna tells him that the idea of oneself is an illusion. The truth is that the Lord controls everybody like the puppeteer controlling the puppets. The classical Tamil epic Shilapathikaram talks about the misfortunes of the goldsmith Kovalam, who on his visit to Madurai falls into the charms of Madhavi, the courtesan. When caught in the clutches of the enchantress Madhavi, Ilango Adigal, the poet, describes Kovalan's situation as that of a puppet who is controlled by the puppeteer. On a typical day, the puppeteers with their puppets, the men who would help in organizing the puppets, and those artists who would lend their voices and put life into these puppets arrive at the venue for yet another performance. They survey the scene because in Bommalatam every stage is impromptu. Like a warrior or a samurai for whom every moment is new, to the puppeteer, every stage is makeshift, it is new, and it has to be erected for every performance. They take out the puppets from their bags and arrange them in the order of their appearance. This ritual goes on backstage. Even as the stage itself is prepared, the village where the performance is to take place provides the necessary amenities to the artist. There are poles that need to be fixed, across which the main curtain is stretched. About 3 to 4 foot in height, these curtains are meant to hide the puppeteer who carries on his manipulation from behind the frame. Like any traditional art, puppetry also has the ritual of propitiating the gods. Traditional arts like Bommalatam, Bhagavata Ata, Bayalata, Yakshagana, Kathakali, Teyyam begin by propitiating the gods. Lord Vinayaka or Ganesha is propitiated along with Lord Shiva. Any performance has to go on uninterrupted and without any hurdle. So Lord Ganesha, who is also Vigneshwara, the remover of all obstacles, is propitiated first. The members of the crew, along with the patrons of the performance, come together in a gesture of community prayer. While the prayer goes on, one or two members of the crew settle down backstage to string the puppets. There was a time in the heyday of puppetry when artists manipulated up to 12 strings. Such dexterity has died a natural death.
இந்த கை ஒன்று இருக்கும், இந்த இடத்துல இருக்கும்.
அப்புறம் இவ்வளோ கையிலும் ஒரே ஆள்
ஒரே ஆள் 12 கை. இந்த இடத்துல சங்கத்துக்கு மேலே ஓர கொடுத்துருப்பாங்க. இப்போ இத்தனம்னா அந்த பேஜை பிடிச்சி எழுதணும், அந்த மாதிரி பண்ணுறது. அதுக்கப்புறம் இது யாரும் பண்ணுறதாக முடியல, கஷ்டம்.
These days, there are no puppeteers who have the skill to manipulate up to 12 strings. Every limb and segment of the puppet in those days could be moved, that even a Bharatanatyam performance was possible with such dexterity from the puppeteer. These days, puppets are controlled on 3 or 4 strings and a few rods to assist in the movements. The puppets are arranged, and when the master puppeteer gets his cue. He takes his seat behind the curtain. He is ready to perform. His assistants wait for his nod to bring on the puppets onto the stage. As in any traditional performance, the opening scene is a gesture of welcome and thanksgiving. The members in the audience are welcomed to the performance. This should go back to the times of the kings and queens. In the context of Tamil Nadu, it is the Raja of Serfoji who ruled in the areas which today comprises the districts of Tanjavur and Mayiladuthurai, who is thanked for his generosity. Legend says that the traditional wooden puppets were originally contributed by the palace. Even the genealogy of puppetry is traced during this gesture of welcome. Obeisance is paid to the great sages and gurus, to Bharata Muni and his Natya Shastra, from which Bommalatam draws its performative aesthetics. It also pays tributes to the local worthies like Kumbakonam Mani Ayyar, who popularized Bommalatam in the southern part of the country. The performer today is Kudandai Chandru, one of the oldest veterans in the field of Bommalatam. He is among the few surviving Bommalatam artists looking desolately towards the evening of his once extraordinary career. Chandru takes his seat behind the curtain and prepares his crew with last minute instructions. He is a ventriloquist. He is a stand-up comedian. He is a poet who can improvise witty lines by the minute. All these talents roll out when the performance begins. Like the screen persona created by Bharathirajaa of the director, who is in complete control of the cinema set, Kudandai Chandru takes charge of his stage. There are many voices that will flow out of his ventriloquist repertoire, and he will bring to life many characters. From the Puranas, there are characters of the gods, Lord Vishnu, Lord Shiva, Brahma, the ubiquitous sage Narada, and today he is performing the Purana of Shani, attempting to capture Vinayaka. Narada is perturbed that Lord Shanishwara has decided to attack Ganesha. He approaches the Trinity to intervene in the matter. Each one of the Trinity expresses his inability to intervene. Lord Shiva is even philosophical that everyone must accept his fate. And when Shanishwara catches anyone, he has to accept it. There is no escape. Sage Narada is sad that Shanishwara, who is believed to cause misery, would soon be visiting Vinayaka. But the remover of obstacles has a few tricks up his own sleeve. He welcomes Shanishwara. He also accepts Shanishwara's terms. A surprised Shanishwara tries to collect himself, by which time Vinayaka requests him that he sign a bond accepting that he would visit Vinayaka the following day. Vinayaka gets this document fixed on his back, and when Chanishwara visits him the following day, he agrees to the terms of the Lord. But when he is asked to accept misery, Vinayaka turns his back on Chanishwara. The Lord, who tests everyone through a phase of trials, begins to see the quick-wittedness of Ganesha and how he himself was outwitted by this trick. Thus, Ganesha in the Puranas is perhaps the only exception, the other being Lord Anjaneya or Hanuman, who have not been caught by the trials of Chanishwara. The puppeteer does not stop with the tales from the Puranas. In these days, when puppetry has to reach out to the masses by touching on topical issues too, Chandru has for this audience the topical issue of terrorism. The lady artist prepares to play the role of a little girl who fell to the bullets of a terrorist. There is the conversation between the terrorist and the ghost of the girl. The terrorist is shocked to hear that he was responsible for taking the life of an innocent child. He is contrite, filled with remorse, and he decides to lay down arms and start living a life of peace. In its long and eventful history, Bommalatam has seen ups and downs. This is the sentiment with which Bharathirajaa opens his film. He says Bommalatam is speckled with Kayangal and Nyayangal. Kayangal meaning wounds and scars, and Nyayangal meaning justice and fairness. This folk form has been a play of the wounds that humanity has suffered, which Bommalatam has taken as its subject, and the sense of justice it has instilled through its messages. All these played out through the nimble finger movements of that magician called the puppeteer.